Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. We've published the teardown video of brand new Samsung 45 fast charger. If you haven't seen it, you can click the upper right corner to take a look. We promised to test its performance and compare it with old 45W and 20W. So here it comes. The packaging contains the charger and cable, and we also took apart this 5M cable. You can click the upper right corner to view it. The charger adopts black matte surface, and we can see the super fast charging on the charger. The prongs cannot be folded, and is equipped with a USB-C port. Flip to the back, model is EP-T4510. It can support 4 fixed pedos and a set of PBS. The size of the charger is 47 and 43 and 28mm. Weight is about 99 grams. It's obviously smaller than Apple 30W charger, and it's slightly smaller than the previous generation of the 45W charger. Neither old or new 45W charger supports 12V, and the PPS are slightly different. The CharlieLab PowerZ KM002C shows it can support QC4, PD3, and PPS protocols. It also supports 4 fixed pedos and 3 sets of PPS. Next, let's test it out with a few devices. Here are the compatibility test results. We've made a chart for you. It can reach 42 to 43 watts when charging 3 MacBooks, but it can only reach 36 to 37 watts when charging S22 Plus. Fortunately, it can support TV mode of switch. This time, we used the Samsung 45W GaN charger to charge the S22 Plus fully. The charging curve is in here. Firstly, we found the obvious fluctuation of the curve. The peak power is 39 watts at 7 minutes 12 seconds. And then the charging power fluctuates regularly between 8 to 37 watts. The power gradually decreased after 47 minutes. It takes about 1 hour and 27 minutes to be fully charged. We also tested the Samsung 25W, old Samsung 45W with Samsung S22 Plus, and compare it with new Samsung 45W GaN charger. In half an hour, the 45W charger is the quickest, and the 25W charger is a little bit slower, but the 45W GaN charger only reaches 57%. At 1 hour, the 25W charger is almost the same as 45W charger, and the 45W GaN charger only reaches 93%. Compared to 45W charger, the 25W charger only needs additional 3 minutes to charge the S22 Plus fully, but the 45W GaN charger needs additional 9 minutes. Except for the PPS, this charger also supports 45W PD protocol, so we use it to fully charge the MacBook Air with M1 chip. This time, the charging curve is more stable, which can be roughly divided into 4 states. The peak power is 42 watts. It can reach 38% in half an hour and 68% in an hour. And it'll take 2 hours and 15 minutes to be fully charged. Most people won't remove the charger after charging their phone. So, is there any power consumption in this case, and how much is it? We can use the power meter to test it. The no-load power consumption of the charger at 220 volts 50 Hz is 0.051 watts, which is about 0.44 kWh in 1 year. And the no-load power consumption at 110 volts 60 Hz is 0.027 watts, which is about 0.23 kWh in 1 year. The charger is essentially a conversion device, so energy will be lost in the process of converting AC to DC. So here is the conversion efficiency test of the charger. The conversion efficiency varies from 87.42% to 89.97% at 220 volts 50 Hz. The conversion efficiency varies from 87.06% to 90.8% at 110 volts 60 Hz. Most chargers adopt switching power supply currently. There will be ripples in the output current. The lower ripple means better quality. Firstly, the input is 220 volts 50 Hz AC. When the output is 5 volts 3 amp, the highest ripple is 222 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is 15 volts 0 amp, the lowest ripple is 76 millivolts peak to peak. Then let's switch the input to 110 volts 60 Hz AC. When the output is 5 volts to amp, the highest ripple is 146 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is 15 volts 0 amp, the lowest ripple is 66 millivolts peak to peak. As we mentioned, in the process of converting AC to DC, energy will be converted into heat. We'll put it into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test and let it run for an hour. And firstly, the maximum temperature on two sides are 61.1 degrees Celsius and 59.8 degrees Celsius under 220 volts, 50 Hz. Then the maximum temperature on two sides are 62.8 degrees Celsius and 66.7 degrees Celsius under 110 volts, 60 Hz. We also monitored the charging curve during temperature testing. The curves are horizontal and straight, without obvious fluctuations. Well, that's all performance tests. The peak power of 45 watts is higher than 25 watts. But due to the obvious power fluctuations of 45 watts, the total charging time is almost the same as 25 watts. The new 45 watts GaN charger is smaller, but the charging speed hasn't improved. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can click the corners to view other Samsung products. If you have this charger or want to buy one, you can share your comments down below. See you in the next video. Bye.